नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर डिस्कसिंग द टॉपिक लेटर्स एंड टुडे आई एम हियर विद द थर्ड लेटर। दिस इज द फोर्थ वीडियो ऑन लेटर, इनफॉर्मल लेटर। एंड आई डिस्कस्ड विद यू टू लेटर्स ऑलरेडी। टुडे आई एम गोइंग डिस्कस विद यू थर्ड लेटर। डियर स्टूडेंट, इफ यू वॉच द वीडियो सीरियसली, यू विल फाइंड I didn't discuss with you three letters. I discussed with you three ways of sharing your emotions, your feeling regarding this type of topic. Okay, so if you want to wish, how you can wish, we have discussed. If you want to advise, how you can advise, I have taught you already. Now this is the third letter. And in this letter, we will learn how to ask about the well-being of our family member, relatives. How we should write whenever there is any problem with them. Okay, so you can read the heading of the letter. Your cousin has met with an accident when he was trying to get off the moving school bus. This is the heading. So your cousin, younger cousin, he may be a naughty boy. Some naughty student. This is very bad habit. Sometimes they try to get off the bus when the bus is getting slow. Whenever they are very close to their stoppage, whenever they are very close to their houses and the bus is getting slowed down to stop, these naughty students sometimes get off the moving bus. They didn't hear the call of driver, they didn't hear the call of conductor. Sometimes they remain deaf of the calls of driver and conductor, and they did their mischief. And this is very bad. So there is a story. Cousin has met with an accident, and we are writing the letter, and you will learn how you can describe your feeling, how you can write the letter of this type. Okay, we are starting. Firstly, heading 278 arose engine. Okay. 278 arose in Clave, then the city town name Visakhapatnam. Then there is, you will leave a line there. And then you will write day there. 8 August. 10. Okay. This is the date. You have left the line there. This is the date. Then you always start your letter with celebration, with wishing. Okay. So he is your younger cousin. So you can write, dear, Kishore. So this is the format. This is the way you have to follow in the letter writing, informal letter writing. First heading. Heading included the center address, then date, and then the celebration. Celebration I have told in the first video. What kind of celebration you have to use? So now we come to the point. Here the cousin is asking about the well-being of his cousin, younger cousin, who got injuries when he was trying to get off the moving bus. He was a naughty type of boy. He didn't care the call of the driver and conductor. So when the bus was slowed down, he tried to get off the moving bus. So how to start letter? I have just heard. I have just heard about your fracture. I have just heard about your fracture. He got the fracture on the leg. So, cousin is writing there. Got. How could? How could you jump? How could you jump out? How could you jump out of the moving bus? So, the elder cousin is expressing his surprise that it is, you know, beyond his understanding how he could jump out of the moving bus. You know, when you are growing up, when you are getting mature, so your maturity is shown when you are doing some mature work. It is not accepted by anyone that if you move out of the moving bus in your class 7, it is not understandable. So all person expect a kind of good behavior from you because you are a growing child. You are in 7th class, very soon you will be in 10th, 12th. So that is not expected. Moving bus, or we can say school bus. School bus, just like that. How could you jump out of the bus just like that? So the elder cousin who is writing is expressing his surprise. You are indeed lucky. You are indeed lucky to have got away with a minor, to have got away with a minor fracture. With a minor fracture, it could have been worse. It could have been worse. For all you know. So the cousin is saying to Kishore, who got fracture, that I have just heard about your fracture. How could you jump out of the moving school bus just like that? This is not a manner of getting off the bus. You are indeed lucky. Even then you are lucky. You have did that thing. Even then you are lucky to have got away with a minor fracture on the leg. Just a minor fracture he got. Okay, so he was lucky. It could have been worse. It could have been more bad. Worse. The condition, the situation can be worse there. He could have been very seriously injured, but he was safe. Okay? Thinking about it, makes me shut up. Shut up means trembling, shivering with fear. Fear of happening something bad. When I imagine this thing, when I think about this thing, when I think about this accident, I got trembling, I got shivering, I feel shut up. It makes me shut up when I think about all these things. So, this is the first para. And how you have to start, it is here. And sometime when you were in 6th or 5th class, sometime you wrote many lines in just asking hello. Hello, my dear brother, how are you? I am fine here. How are you there? How are your family members? So don't waste your letter, lines. Don't waste your lines in asking unnecessary thing. Always start discussing about the main thing. The first para is for introducing your reason of letter. Okay? The first para should make the audience or should make the checker that you are what you are going to write. Now the second para you will see. How we develop his ideas, his thought in the second para. You will see, and you will follow the same kind of thing. Be habitual, be perfect in expressing your thoughts, expressing your concern, expressing your views. So now, the second para. How are you feeling now? How are you feeling now? Feeling now with the cast. How are you feeling now with the cast on? Cast means plaster. How are you feeling now with the cast on? With the cast on the leg, plaster is on the leg. So how are you feeling now? You know, sometimes some children, some persons are in the habit. They don't like to stay in one place. They don't like to be in a lazy position. They like to move every time. They like to go here and there. Does it hurt? Does it hurt? He is asking, does it hurt? He is also advising there, you are a brave boy. You are a brave boy. You are a brave boy. I'm sure you will be able to bear any pain, able to bear any pain. When you see a person in problem, say this type of words to them. Don't laugh. If person is feeling fear, having some problems, facing any difficulties, don't laugh on him or on her. Give them courage. Give them morale. Okay. By the way, the next time, By the way, how many of How many of your friends? How many of your friends scribble? How many of your friends scribble? Get well. Get well. Get well. Soon. Messages. Messages and phone numbers. Phone numbers on the task. So he is also trying to make his cousin relax. So firstly, he asked about the accident, and then he also scolded his cousin for that type of behavior. But then suddenly he is trying to encourage his cousin Kishore, and then he is changing his mood. When you talk about the friends of any person, he or she will feel a kind of happiness. So he also discussed about this friend and asked, how many of your friends scribble, written, get well seen on your plaster cast and for their phone numbers. Okay, the second para, the main para, how are you feeling now with the cast on? Does it hurt? Does it hurt? Does it hurt? You are a brave boy. I'm sure you'll be able to bear any pain. By the way, how many of your friends will get well soon messages and phone numbers on the cast? Okay, so now we are also going towards the concluding the para of and the last para of the letter. So now we will listen to the last para. I'm glad. I'm glad that a friend of yours, that a friend of yours, a friend of yours is keeping you posted of the happening, a friend of yours is keeping you posted of the happenings. Happenings in the class. So, when this type of thing happens with somebody, so some friends play their role very honestly. If a person is not attending classes, not coming to school, it is the duty of his friends to keep him aware about the activities of the class, happenings of the class. So it is a good thing of the friend three weeks in cast means plaster, is nothing. So again, the elder cousin is encouraging his younger cousin that don't worry, 3 weeks in caste is nothing. Don't worry. Just chill. Just chill, man. Don't worry, just chill, man. Or sometimes we say this word man to growing boys, to younger boys, to make them show, to make them believe that they are men, and men are known to bear any kind of pain. Although there is no difference between men and women, there is no difference, but still we say this type of words. You are a man, so don't cry over a trifle, over a small issue, and show your braveness, show your courageness. The same kind of a beautiful letter is this. Student, if you see, it is a beautiful compact of feeling. He did everything in this letter, the elder cousin, which is needed, which is important for the younger cousin. Okay, so now the next line. So 3 weeks in class is nothing, don't worry, just chill. Okay, so now we are closing. I'll come to see you soon. I'll come to see you soon. Yours. Ashutosh. Yours. Ashutosh. So Ashutosh was the elder brother who was writing the letter to younger cousin. So these student, I told you three letters. I told you these were not letters. These are three type of feelings that can make you able to share your feeling with your dearest one, with your relatives. So watch all the videos of the letters and be perfect in writing informal letter. Okay, students, namaste.